It was on the 5th of August, the weather was unfair, and to repair I did the repair, for love I was inclined. I got up with the lark in the morning, with me heart so full of glee, expecting near to meet my dear long time I wish to see. Near Oldham Town, near Oldham Town, as I ever then fell, there once was a white head, a future for to dwell. He'd been haunted by the eagles and greyhounds of fair, but near the one the mountain put so near the fell white hair, with the light on the little dog, the light on the day. They went to the place where the white hair used to lie. They uncoupled the beagles at the beginning for to try. They uncoupled the beagles and they bit the bushes round. But there was never a white hair not near to be found. The light on the little round, the light on the day. There was Jim Smith, the huntsman, and Tom the whipperin. Go down to yonder first, I just see you see the inn. With that she took the jumpy boy, and away she did run. And yonder she is going, don't you see a gentleman? With me light on the diddle, down the light on the day. They put men, they did run, and the horsemen, they did ride. The tall wind and shouting, there was on every side. The tall wind and shouting, I never before had known. And all the men kept crying, Tally-o, with me right on the vittles, all the right on the day. There was 20 good diggers that caused the dead to die. There was not one amongst them that pulled there to tie. The number of the dogs there never could be found. Never better run in the pond of English ground. With me right on the diggers, all the right on the day. They say that 40 gallon poachers there was in the mess. They'd often been attacked when the number it was less. So poacher bold, if I would fall, keep up your gallant heart. And think about those poachers bold that night in Rufford's Park. Nay, book our door, believe it so, where seven are the mayor, was sent on there for everyone, quite equal for to share. So, poachers bold, as I would fall, keep up your gallant heart, and think about those poachers bold, that night in your face. The keepers, they begun the fight with stones and with the flails. But when the poachers started wilder to slit on their tails, the poachers bawled as I wouldn't fall, keep up your gallant heart, and think about those poachers bawled that night in Rufford's Park. Lord Bateman was a noble lord, a noble lord of some high degree. He shipped himself on board of a ship, some foreign country he was for sea. He sailed east and he sailed west, until he came to put out the key. Where he was taken and put in prison until his life it grew quite weary. And in this prison there grew a tree. It grew so large and it grew so strong. Where he was seen at around the middle until his life it was almost gone. His jailer had but one only daughter, the fairest creature my two eyes did see. She stole the keys of her father's prison and said, Lord Bateman, she would set free. Now have you got houses, have you got land, and does not stumble and belong to thee? And what would you give to that fair young lady? The count of prison would set you free. Yes, I've got houses and I've got land, and I've no stumble and belongs to me. I would give it all to that fair young lady. The count of prison would set me free.
Oh, from this little town they came.
young man's name was William Taylor, the maiden's name was Sarah Gray. William Taylor, he has listed for a soldier, he has gone. He has gone and left his own to love for to try and for to learn. Well, it's fair and it despises the field of artist's grief and woe. He vowed and fed the soldier, for the soldier he would go. He dressed the saddle-fed man, the parried man, the parried would he put on. Then for to seek a long true lover, for to seek him she has gone. One day as we were exercising one, two, three, a silver chain hung down her waistcoat and exposed her lily white breast. The sergeant major stepped up to her, asking her what brought her there. I come in search of my true lover, who has proved to me so dear. If you come to seek your own true lover, I pray you tell to me his name. His name it is Bold William Taylor, oh, from Lichfield town he came. If his name be William Taylor, William Taylor is not here. He's lately married a rich young lady, worth £10,000 a year. If you rise early in the morning, just before the break of day, why, dear, you'll find Bold William Taylor walking out with his lady fair. Then she goes early in the morning, just before the break of day, and this is by Bold William Taylor walking out with his lady fair. And then she calls for a sword and a pistol, which was brought at a command. She fired and shot Bold William Taylor with his bride at his right hand. And then the captain stepped up to where was well pleased at what she'd done. He took and made the bold commander over the ship and all his men.
Then it's your time after this fair young damsel.
was invited to a ball, you know. This wicked young man, he followed after and soon prepared for her overthrow. As she was dancing on with another, jealousy it filled his mind. Then to destroy his untrue lover, this wicked young man he was inclined. Then quickly he prepared some poison and mixed it with a glass of wine and gave it to his untrue lover. She drank it with that most tearful mind. A little love to this fair young damsel. Now take me, oh my dear, says she, for the liquor that you have lately gave me, it makes me very ill indeed. As they was walking along together, he then known to as it said, I gave you poison in your liquor, all for to take your sweet life away. And I have drunk of the same I do will, I soon shall die as well as thee. So in each other's arms that die, yet young men be aware of jealousy.
Well, drinking hail, and it's nice to
have a drop of wine. Would I like sit inside the young man's sky? That game at this heart of mine. My father is the king of the gypsies that he steals. My mother, she'll manage me some something for to do. They put the fact upon me, but they all did with me well. So I set up for London town some fortune for to tell. As I was a-walking the fair London street, a handsome young squire I chanted for to meet. He viewed my brown cheeks, and he liked them so well. He felt me little gypsy girls in human fortune fair. Why, yes, fine fairies give me hold of the land. Why, you have got houses, you've riches and you've land. Put all those pretty ladies, human, put them to one side. For I'm the little gypsy girl that used to be your bride. Now, once I was a gypsy girl, but now a quiet bride. I've got 7 parts away from me, and in me cottage lies. The bells they rung so merrily, and the sweetly rigid cry, and the jolly time we had upon the gypsy's wedding day. Oh, where are you going to, my pretty friend? Where are you going to, my pretty man? I'm going to milk in Sarsyland. I'm going to milk in Sarsyland. Why, might I go with you, my pretty man? Might I go with you, my pretty man? Oh, yes, yes, please, I'm Sarsyland, I'm Sarsyland.
Along with the rest of all the long to rest.
on the road of 51, from Saturn in Crete in Jaino. Why she never saw a man or a delving in her life, that she probably told her what was at the tomb of the Caidia, the mister of the Caidia. Why she never saw a man or a delving in her life, that she probably told her what was at the tomb of the Caidia. When Creeping Jane on the race course came, the gentlemen really they all led round and go, and all they had to say concerning little Jane, she's not able for to gather for the ground of the daisy, the people of the daisy, and all they had to say concerning little Jane, she's not able for to gather for the ground of the daisy. Now when that they came to the second mile post, Stephen Jane, he was far behind, oh. Then the rider flung the whip around the ball of little neck, and he said, me little lassie, never mind all the daisy, hey, the little of the daisy, oh. Then the rider flung the whip around the ball of little neck, and he said, me little lassie, never mind all the daisy. Now when that they came to the third mile post, Creeping Jane, he looked blind and smart, oh. And then she lifted up a little lily white foot, and she flew past them all like a dart, all the daisy, hey, the little all the daisy, oh. And then she lifted up a little lily white foot, and she flew past them all like a dart, all the daisy. Now Creeping Jane, he was raised as one, and scarcely sweat one drop, oh. Why she's able for to gallop the ground o'er again, while the others is not able for to slept long the day. Now Creeping Jane, he's dead and gone, and her body lies on the cold ground, oh. I'll go down to the master and tell her for to say, let me keep a little body from the arms of the daisy, the distal of the daisy. I'll go down to the master and tell her for to say, let me keep a little body from the arms of the daisy.
Now tell me, when you were young, you remember Joseph Taylor singing in the family. Would it be of an evening or when would that be?
Oh, in the evenings, yes. Oh, yes, in the evenings. We used to sit round winter evenings. You see, that was our sort of entertainment. And, of course, he was a member of the church choir, always. We always had to go to church and we were all in the choir, every member of the family, and we were all singers. Winter evenings, we'd go into each other's houses, and we'd have an old harmonium or something like that, and be singing, and then perhaps it was our turn, and then we'd go to Mr. Sanderson's and different houses and sing in the evenings.
Perhaps. When you hear people singing nowadays, how does it differ from his style of singing?
The folk songs, the old songs that he used to sing, he used to put in the little turns and twiddles that you don't hear nowadays.
Now tell me about your father, what work he did and so on, and his father and so on.
I don't really know what his father was. Might have been a giant, but he came here as a woodman and worked in the woods. Then he got to be the foreman, and then after that, he was when he died, he was the farm bailiff. I know it, yes. Mm. And he was born at Binbrook.
Near Market Raisin?
Near Market Raisin, yes. And he loved Binbrook. That's where he learned. Brick Fair.
Yes.
We think it used to, round about Binbrook, the gypsies used to camp, and as a lad, he would go round to them and watch them getting their suppers, and they'd be singing. And we think it's possibly there where they heard Brig Fair, because, of course, the gypsies all come, still, I believe, come to Brig Fair. His favourite was the White Hare, which I can't remember. I can't remember the tune. My niece remembers it very well. I heard her sing it in Brig the other day.